Hi folks, Jeremy Shafer here. Today I'm going to show you how to fold a multiple rippling deltoid design that transforms into a multiple rippling deltoid pyramid. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. Alright, so for this model we're going to use an ordinary square of printer paper. Well, here we have a rectangle, so let's transform it into a square. So we're going to take the short edge and fold it onto the long edge. Sharply, and let's rotate 90 degrees, and let's turn over right to left, and now we're going to fold this edge up, and we're going to fold right on this edge right here. Okay, and let's crease sharply, okay, and completely unfold. Alright, and let's take this flap and let's fold it back and forth a few times just to make this crease nice and sharp and loose. Alright, so you could use scissors and cut right along here and then you'd have a square, but I'm going to show you how to tear it. So the first thing is you want to just tear right at the top, make a tiny little tear right there. Okay, and now you want to push it together so that you end up making like a ridge right here. And with your hands like this, you're just going to separate your hands and tear all the way down the ridge. Just like that. Okay, and here we have our square. All right, well, we already folded it diagonally like that. Now let's fold it diagonally in this direction. We're going to make a water bomb base. Okay, so now let's take this corner and fold up to here. And let's turn over right to left, and let's take this corner and fold it up to here. Okay, crease sharply. And now open this pocket right here, and put your hand inside, and now just close the left and right sides together like this, and flatten it down so that it's a triangle. Okay, now let's take this corner and let's fold it right to the middle, right to where this crease hits the edge, just like that. And let's do the same thing on the other side. Okay, and let's turn over and do the same thing on this side. So this corner goes right to here. And same thing here. Okay, crease sharply and unfold these flaps, and let's turn over and unfold here. And now we're just going to fold the corners up to the top. So here we go. One, two, and crease sharply and turn over right to left, and three, four. Okay, now we're going to rotate 90 degrees, and let's take this flap, and we're going to fold it right to the middle. Okay, crease sharply, and let's rotate 180 degrees, and let's take this flap and fold it right to the middle. Kind of like we're making a water bomb. All right, now unfold and unfold. And now we're going to take this flap and fold right to the intersection of these creases. Right there. Okay, and unfold. And let's rotate 180 degrees. And let's take this flap and fold it to the intersection of these creases. Okay, and unfold. And now let's take this flap and fold to this intersection. Okay, and rotate 180 degrees and fold this corner right to this intersection. And now let's turn over bottom to top. And let's do the same thing. So let's fold this corner to the middle and rotate, and let's fold this corner to the middle and unfold and unfold and fold this corner to right here and unfold and rotate, and let's take this corner and fold to right here. And let's take this corner and fold to right here, the first crease. Unfold and rotate, and let's take this corner and fold to right here. Okay, now let's take this whole flap, one flap, and fold it up. And let's turn over bottom to top. And let's fold this front flap up. Okay. All right, so here we have our middle crease, and let's go down one crease to right here, and let's form it as a mountain fold. So we're just pinching it, just like this. This is what it looks like from the side. So lift it up, and we're going to place it right on our middle crease. Just like that. And now let's go to the crease below right here, and let's lift this up as a ridge, and we're going to fold it right up to this edge. Okay, and let's now do this crease, form it as a ridge, and fold it right up to here. And lastly, just fold this corner up. Like that. Now make these creases as sharp as you can and unfold the flap. And let's rotate 180 degrees and let's do the same thing on this side. So here we have our middle crease and we go one below right here, lift up the crease and fold it onto the middle and go down just like that. Lift up and fold up. And here, and here. Okay, and unfold. And now let's turn over bottom to top. And let's do the same thing on this side. And unfold, and let's rotate 180 degrees, and one more time. Okay, and unfold. All right, now just completely unfold it. Okay, so here we have our water bomb base. And let's unfold the water bomb base. All right, so now let's just fold in half. And fold in half this way. Okay, and now let's take this half and fold in half like this. Okay, so let's open it up and you should see four raw corners right here. So the first one, what we're going to do is take this interior flap right here, okay, and we're going to fold it to right here, but we're folding it inside. So right on the crease, we're just folding it right to there, just like that. Okay. Now the next one, right here, the next one, we're actually going to reverse fold it. So we're going to take this flap and we're going to reverse it into this pocket right here. So here we go. We just push it down right on the crease right here and flatten. Okay, now the next corner right here is, once again, we're just going to fold it over like this. Okay, and the last point, let's go onto this side and we're going to reverse fold it. So just push it down and close it up. All right. So the idea here is that when you open here, there should be an equal number of layers on this side and this side. And we have this pyramid looking thing. And this is what it looks like from inside. All right, now what we're going to do is do some sinking. So we're first going to sink right on this crease right here. This is a mountain, and then the valley is right here. So here we go. So we just hold it like this. My other hand is inside to provide support, and I'm just gonna push it in like this, and then pinch around this triangle. And don't worry if it gets a little crumpled. You just want to shape it like this. So now you can go underneath and try to fix it up like this. But the easiest way to fix it up is just squeeze the sides like that. There it goes, just like that. Okay. So here we have our first sink. Now we're going to go down two creases. So this is going to be our valley, and then this is our mountain. So I'm going to just draw that mountain for you guys. Okay, and then the valley is up here. All right, so here we go. Let's just basically just fold right on the mountain fold and just push in where you need to. Like push in at the corner. That's the part that's a little bit harder. But the nice thing is that all of the creases are already in, so the paper is going to want to go right on the creases that you made during the pre-creasing. So it's just like that. And there you have it. And then let's go down to the next one, make a mountain fold. And the valley in between. Okay. And lastly, we're going to make a valley right on that outside crease. So, let's fold it up and just flip these corners up. Flip. And flip. Okay, and there it is. And you can just sort of squeeze it together to make these creases as sharp as can be. All right, and here we have it. So to open it, what you're going to do is separate these two corners. They're the only corners that will separate, and open up like this. And now just grab the outer edges like this and separate. And here you have your pyramid. Now, it looks okay like this, but there's one little crease that is good if you can make. This right here should be a mountain fold. So just carefully with your hand inside here, just pinch right along and make it a mountain fold all the way up to the corner. And there it is. And from the inside, that's what it looks like. And what's nice about this is that you can collapse it either this way, or you can collapse it this way. And you can put it away like this. You just collapse it. Just like that. And then when you want to open it, it's best to just hold the outer edges just like that. There it is. And once again, you want to make this as a mountain fold so that it's symmetrical. There it is. All right, now bring it back. Okay, another thing that you can do is that you can transform this into, instead of concentric triangles, it can be a triangular spiral that goes around. So this is how you do it. You want to find the center of the square, of the original square. This is the center. We're not going to touch this area. So you can either choose the left side or the right side, but not the center of the original square. So what we're going to do is, let's turn over right to left. Here's the center. Don't touch that. So the spiral, let's make it go around clockwise. So we're going to make it open up right here. So we're going to continue this crease to the right, like that. Okay, so we have our spiral that goes in here, around, around, and now it needs to connect with this path. So we're going to take this mountain and continue it to the right, to right there. And this valley also continues to the right, to right here. And let's squeeze right like that. All right, so here we have our path that goes around here, 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 and now it needs to connect to right here. So we're going to take this mountain and continue it to the right. Okay, and the valley inside there, continue that to the right. And let's squeeze right here. Okay, and so we're coming around. Now we have to connect this to right in here. So let's just make this as a mountain fold right there, right up from the corner to the right. Okay, and right underneath is a valley fold. And once again, we're going to squeeze the corner and squeeze. Keep squeezing, and there it is. And there's the spiral. All right. And once again, we can open it up. So, like that. And separate the two sides like that. And there is the multiple rippling deltoid spiral pyramid. Okay, and it can also be a hat. And if you want, you can make the hat fit a little bit better by pulling this out like this. And, well, you can just go out like that. But you can fix it up a little bit. Let's bring the concentric squares. Oh, actually, it could be a spiral. Coming around here. Mountain, 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 mountain. Yeah, that's good. Like that. So there we have the spiral. And here you have a bird mouth. Spiral of squares. And it's also a hat with a hyperbolic paraboloid as a visor. All right, well, I hope you guys like that and let me know what you think. See you later. If you want, you can try to put two together by just inserting it inside like this. And here you either have a geometric shape like that, or you have a talking bird mouth. And you could insert another one, I'm sure, too. And you'd have an octahedron. All right, see you later.